This work obviously alludes to a biblical episode that can also be related to the history of Africa. Moses and the Egyptians and Man from Naples, both completed in 1982, were created at a particularly important moment in the career of Jean-Michel Basquiat, after his discovery as an artist, and before his period of maximum productivity. Both pieces are essential for understanding the development of his painting during the 1980s. At the center of the composition, one can distinguish the profile of Moses suggested with some white lines that appear to be the result of an instantaneous, unpremeditated impulse. This same color not only envelops the gigantic tablets of the law, but extend around the prophet's profile in the form of expressive drips and drops. The tablets also contain a series of inscriptions in an arrangement that looks more orderly and contained, unlike the one in Man from Naples.
Jean-Michel was going to make things happen in the creative space by any means necessary.
Check it out. He did whatever he needed to do in order to be a painter and in order to be an artist. And I think it takes a tremendous amount of balls to do that.
I'd never seen a black artist with this kind of unbelievable talent and unbelievable charisma.
A sky blue canvas ripped open by an enormous skull, teeth bared through visceral slashes of oil and spray paint. In 2017, this untitled artwork was auctioned off for over $110 million. But it's not the work of some old master. These strokes of genius belong to 21-year-old black Brooklynite Jean-Michel Basquiat, one of America's most charismatic painters and currently its highest sold. Born in 1960 to a Haitian father and a Puerto Rican mother, Basquiat spent his childhood making art and mischief in Borum Hill. While he never attended art school, he learned by wandering through New York galleries and listening to the music his father played at home. He drew inspiration from unexpected places, scribbling his own versions of cartoons, comic books, and biblical scenes on scrap paper from his father's office. But it was a medical encyclopedia that arguably exerted the most powerful influence on Basquiat.